Previously on Jimmy Kimmel Live.
What the f*** are you doing? I caught you red-handed again.
From Hollywood, it's Jimmy Kimmel Live. Tonight, Sarah Silverman, Molly Bonds, and music from Dwight Yoakam with Cleto and the Cleto. And now, Jimmy Kimmel!
But it's Golden Bachelor Night here on ABC, the season finale of How Grandpa Got His Groove Back after a long and emotional journey. Bachelor Gary, or Gary, or Jerry, or whatever the hell his name is, finally chose the woman he'll share the rest of his reverse mortgage with, and he finally found the centrum to his silver.
I got to the point with the questions I had asked myself about how did I get here, and is she the right girl, and I came to the realization that you're not the right person for me to live with. Oh. You're the person that I can't live without.
Oh my God.
Now hold on a minute, because I met this guy, Gary. He seemed like a nice, normal man. But anyone who can do that, anyone who can Ryan Seacrest a moment like that, like the one where you tell the woman that you love her, is a psychopath, okay? How could you ever trust that person again? He looked right in her eyes and basically told her she was gonna die alone. And I went, oh, no, just kidding. It's sick. It's the mark of a sick individual. But I guess it didn't bother Teresa because... They're engaged. And guess what else? They're getting married just as they got engaged on TV, live January 4th here on ABC. A month from now, they're getting married. I guess at their age, we can't take any chances. And one of our writers, by the way, Jamie, who works here, got a string of texts from her mom during the finale. Her mom was babysitting her son, and her mom started texting. She wrote, he just went to bed, sweetest, easiest kid. Which is, by the way, how your parents tell you you were a pain in the ass. But anyway, now I'll watch Golden Bachelor on your computer. Opening the computer, Leslie has beautiful legs. She just does. They don't tell us who wins, although I know it's Teresa. Wow, Leslie has too much life in her, and she's got too much going on. I'm having some wine. He really likes the little tiny one with the pretty legs, Teresa. I think I got them confused. The little tiny one, Teresa, that's who he picks? The one who dated Prince, he's not into as much. Prince was wonderful. Well, she's right, Prince was wonderful. And I think Jamie's mom was drinking like it was 1999, but congratulations to Gary and the one who didn't date Prince. If you want to buy them a gift, they're registered at Crematorium and Barrel, and... Meanwhile, in Washington, the other big finale scheduled for tomorrow night is the political career of Congressman George Santos.
It's been difficult. I have fallen in love with Teresa.
Do you know how humiliating that is?
Things have changed. Things have evolved.
It's embarrassing. It's humbling.
You're both wonderful, but only one of you is right.
I know we can disagree and agree to disagree on that.
I am so sorry.
Yeah, I really thought those two had a chance. But anyway, the House is expected to vote tomorrow on whether or not to expel Santos. Why this is taking so long, I have no... This is like if a mental patient escaped the hospital and wandered into an air traffic control tower, and then a year later, he was still up there landing planes. But George Santos, he's making the most of his remaining time in the spotlight. He had a fiery press conference in front of the Capitol today.
And then just give them the option to change their votes this time around.
Mr. George Santos.
First time I give you a question.
Thank you, Mr. George Santos.
Guillermo from Jimmy Kimmel Live.
Good to see you here.
Thank you. Mr. George Santos, does anything come between you and your Calvins?
No, no, nothing, nothing. Absolutely nothing. These are 6 years old.
Yuck. Thank you, George Santos. Have a good time in jail.
Thank you.
All right, well, good job, Guillermo. You got straight to the meat of it. You don't waste time. It's
why
you're the best.
I'm the best.
But this is historic. Only 5 members of the House have been kicked out ever. Only 2 since the Civil War. But George Santos said this doesn't mean that it's goodbye forever, which is exactly what you expect to hear from someone who's about to say goodbye forever. But the good news is, even though his fellow Republicans are shoving him out the door, he's still committed to helping them win the big election in 2024.
We also have an entire presidential campaign coming up in 2024. And, you know, I think I've made this very clear, but I won't rest until I see Donald Trump back in the White House.
He also won't rest because of the diet pills, but that's another thing entirely. Wow, the coveted George Santos endorsement. Trump must be ecstatic. I think maybe we found his running mate. Wouldn't that be great? You know, it's going to be funny when Republicans and Democrats vote him out of the House tomorrow, and even funnier 6 months from now when he gets voted out of the Celebrity Big Brother house by Snooki and Flava Flav. There's a new Donald Trump movie in the works. It's called The Apprentice. It has nothing to do with the show The Apprentice. It's the story of a young Donald Trump building his real estate empire in the 70s and 80s, which is the time period after his father gave him everything, but before he went bankrupt 4 times. Trump will be played by Sebastian Stan. If you don't know Sebastian Stan, here is a picture of him doing the exact opposite of preparing to play Trump. The only rings Donald touches are onion, but Maria Bakalova is gonna play Trump's first wife, Ivana. You may remember Maria from Borat 2, where Rudy came this close to showing her his Giuliani. How did we forget that, by the way? That should be on a continuous loop and on every gas station pump in America. This is good. According to the Washington Post, former Speaker of the House, Kevin McCarthy, who famously denounced Trump after January 6th, then came scurrying back to suckle his teats 3 weeks later, lashed out at Trump. McCarthy called Trump to complain that Trump didn't do enough to help him keep his job as Speaker, and he's been telling people he got so upset he said, F you, to Trump on the... I feel bad for Kevin. Who would have guessed the guy who turns on everyone he's ever met wouldn't have his back when it came to crunch time? But now the new Speaker of the House is Mike Johnson. I realize this today. Mike Johnson is a dead ringer for the elf on the shelf. He's like... they're like the same guy. Tonight's the night, by the way. December 1st, which is about 15 minutes from now, is day 1 for the elf on a shelf. So if you forgot, you need to get out of bed, climb up to the attic, dig through boxes until you find that little felt narc and make him do something cute. I hate it. It's a pain. I always forget, and it's always having to find a new hiding spot. Actually gives me a lot of sympathy for Melania. But it is... the season of the elf, and with Christmas around the corner, Guillermo and I, as we do every year, slipped into our tights to help Santa figure out which kids have been naughty and which kids have been nice.
Hello, boys. How are you?
Good.
Welcome, welcome. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
What are your names?
Ethan. Lucas.
Are you brothers?
Yes.
Which one of you is older?
Me.
How do you know?
Because I'm 8 and he's 6.
Yeah, but how do you really know?
Because he's taller.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. All right, that's good. Are these your notes for Santa, your lists? Okay, let's have a look at those. Thank you very much. Have you guys been really, really good this year?
Yes. Yeah.
You promise?
Yeah.
Because I've heard you've done some bad things. You know, we're always watching, right? I've heard that sometimes, Ethan, you read past bedtime.
Yeah.
You don't like when your mom sings.
That's Lucas.
That's you? Why don't you like it when your mom sings?
I kind of do, but I sometimes don't because it kind of doesn't sound good sometimes.
It doesn't sound good? Is she not a good singer?
Well, she is, but it doesn't sound good to me sometimes.
To you. And yet, isn't it interesting that this person who brought you into this world, who sacrificed so much, who loves you more than anyone, when she opens her mouth to bring herself just a little bit of joy in an otherwise very difficult day, it bothers you.
A bitch.
A bitch. Yeah. Isn't that weird?
Now, this one is, Lucas, you will sometimes lay on the ground and refuse to move. Is that true?
A bit. Sometimes.
Sometimes? We have a picture of one of those times. Tell me what's going on there.
I needed to get some sunlight.
Oh, you're just trying to get some sunlight? Oh, you're just trying to get a little tan there? And your parents, though, thought you were being difficult. But really, you're just trying to get a little color. Yeah. Did you explain that to them?
Well, I forgot to, but I'll tell them that.
Okay, you can tell them. Maybe while your mom's singing. Yeah? Okay. Did you hear anything? Did you hear that?
Oh, yeah. That's the ice cream truck.
Oh. Can you guys do us a favor? We're gonna run and get some ice cream. But don't tell Santa Claus, okay, if he calls, because we're supposed to be working right now.
Don't say nothing about ice cream, okay?
Okay. Thank you. We'll be right back.
All right.
Ho, 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 ho! Merry Christmas!
Hi. Hi.
Have you been nice? Oh, naughty.
Nice, nice.
What happened to my helpers? To my two elves? Where did they go?
They went to go get some firewood for the fire.
They did not went to get ice cream, right?
No.
Yeah, they didn't.
All right, guys, thanks for waiting. I appreciate it. Santa didn't call, did he?
Oh, Elf, what do you have in your hands?
I just went to go get the boys an ice cream cone.
Hmm?
Because they asked for ice cream.
No.
You asked for ice cream?
Yes, Santa, they asked for ice cream.
Mm-mm.
I thought you said they went to go get wood.
Well, that's what they told us.
No, I said, would you like me to go get ice cream?
We didn't ask for ice cream, Santa. He got the ice cream.
I didn't go get ice cream. I don't even like ice cream.
Lucas, Ethan, do we punish him?
Make him clean the reindeer stall. Yeah.
No, but they poop everywhere. It's disgusting. Don't make me clean the reindeer, Santa.
Go clean now.
Oh, you think this is funny, huh?
Not that funny.
I hate to give you anything. I got some surgical gloves for you.
Huh?
And for you, Mitt Romney's autobiography. Romney. Have a lousy Christmas, you two punks.
Oh, ho, 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 Merry Christmas.
All right, well, thanks, kids.